I will
do my duty,
without fear,
or favor,
affection,
or ill will.
Or ill will.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Today marks another milestone in the social cultural development of the Emirate. The emergence of a new emir, the naming factor for North State, always calls for a celebration, and the new Emirate cannot be an exception. The historical antecedents of Babur Strokbra and other people of North State are not only in the wine, but are indeed two sides of the same coin. We are one people united by different historical events. This morning we have heard from Ambassador Ndiu that His Royal Highness, the first Emir of Biu, is a Kanuri man. And therefore, all of us are the same. The selection of the new Emir of Biu after the sad demise of my Umar Mustafa Ali of blessed memory was characterized by a peaceful and harmonious process. As a matter of fact, I had no reservation in working in tandem with the kingmakers of the Emirate. In arriving at the most deserving personality, based on extant laws, an age-old tradition of the Emirate, for a peaceful succession process devoid of rancor or infidels. Here, I am therefore full of gratitude to Almighty Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful and compassionate, for sparing our lives to stand here at this auspicious occasion of the swearing-in and symbolic presentation of staff of office to the first-class Emir of Biu, His Royal Highness, Alhaji Mustafa Umar Mustafa II, Umar Mustafa II, who was traditionally Taban on 21st September 2020. May I use this medium to commend the effort of the federal government and in particular the Nigerian military for recent successes they have recorded in defeating the insurgents, especially by taking the war into the enclaves of the insurgents. I must commend the Chief of Army Staff, the Chief of Air Staff, Directors and Principal Officers of the Army Headquarters, the Theater Commander, the GOC Central Commanders, the Head Commanders, Commanding Officers, men and officers of the Nigerian Army, men and officers of the Nigerian Military Police, and other paramilitary, civilian JTF, hunters and vigilante, for the support they have rendered in securing the territorial integrity of our nation. Let me also use this opportunity to express my profound appreciation to the Chief of Army Staff for establishing the Biu University. The establishment of this university has indeed lightened the burden of Borno State government in establishing university, another university in Borno State. And therefore, this administration, under my distinguished leadership, will provide all the necessary support to the Nigerian Army University with a view to fulfilling its mandate of its establishment. The distinguished invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, let me also reaffirm our commitment to uplifting the standard of living of our people, despite the numerous challenges occasioned by the lingering security challenges and the coronavirus pandemic. We must ensure that we have to do our part within the limited resources at our disposal to better the lives of our people. It is imperative to also note that in our unrelenting quest to bring human growth to the people, we have undertaken quite a number of projects spread across the four local government areas of the state of the island. This includes the building of areas palaces and construction of 2 district palaces in Bayo local government, construction of local government secretariat in Biu and Bayo local government, overlaying of Biu-Bantu road, which is ongoing, construction and renovation of Jalan Bostad Biu, as well as ongoing construction of high Islamic school at Biu. Others are construction of leather schools at Biu, Bayakutan and Bayo local government, and 12 classrooms at town. Construction of modern markets at Bayakutan town, and electrification of 9 villages in our local government areas among them. As you are all aware that yesterday, we commissioned primary healthcare center at Baratai Village, and the central mosque, as well as track up of distribution of vehicles, tricycles and cash, empowerment packages to members of road transport workers, tricycle association and traders and factory.